One of the most remarkable people in the history of paleontology is Mary Anik. We have a special display on her because her position in the discovery of prehistoric monsters is just without equal. She was born in 1799 in a small town called Lyme Regis on the south coast of England, in Dorset. And when she was only 12 years old, she and her brother found the first ichthyosaur. She didn't get credit for it, however, because back then women weren't allowed to be members of scientific societies. But she would send her finds to leading scientists and they would write them up. And she often complained that they would add a little. And then when she read the paper that they published on it, she would write to her friends, well, they exaggerated a little bit in exactly what was found. She was very meticulous, very scientific, and very precise. Her family was very poor. They were actually collecting fossils because they were trying to sell them to get food. She would collect fossils along the seashore near Lyme Regis, and she had a little stand in town where she would put the fossils out and people would buy them. And in fact, Mary Anning is the person that is the inspiration for the rhyme, "She sells seashells by the seashore." She lived in poverty her whole life. Her father died early. She and her mother could not make ends meet. Several times the scientists, although they didn't give her credit in the scientific journals when they published her work, they often came to her aid. And William Buckland went to the government and said, "You need to give Mary Anning a pension because she has contributed more to the discovery of these animals than anyone else." And the government did. They gave her a pension. In addition to the ichthyosaur, which she and her brother found the first one, she has a number of firsts. She found the first plesiosaur, which is a long-necked marine animal, and she also found the first pterosaur ever found in England. It's called the Dimorphodon macronix. She was first to discover the plesiosaur, first to discover the ichthyosaur. She was a groundbreaking, highly productive paleontologist and one of the great early female scientists of all time.
Well, hopefully exhibits like this one inspire people to dive deeper into very specific subject areas like Mary Anning. We often hear feedback from some of our visitors like that, that they would have never known to want to investigate something deeper like a woman, a female scientist, although self-taught, a female scientist that really changed the trajectory of that field and dive deeper into it. Otherwise, if it wasn't for exhibits like this, many of the general public, wouldn't have access to that kind of and be able to dive deeper if they're interested in there.
She sells seashells by the seashore. The shells she sells are seashells, I'm sure. So if she sells seashells on the seashore, then I'm sure she sells seashore shells.